Hi everyone, my name is Ed DaCosta of eddacosta.com, and this is my video blog for Wednesday, May 28th, 2014. The subject today, people do what they see. Now, I have been blessed to be around some great leaders throughout my life. I've been around some not so great leaders, but I really, really cherish the opportunities that I've had to be around people that are really at the top of their field in terms of leading in business, leading in non-for-profit, in faith-based communities, and also in the educational field. And although all of these areas of human activity are unique and have their differences, there are some very common themes as well. And it just struck me during a recent conversation about the parallels between all of these areas, all of these domains, and it has to do with human nature and how people learn. What am I getting at? I was having a conversation recently with my father-in-law, Tom Lombardi, who is a retired professor of special education. So his entire life was about how does one reach out and educate and help people with special needs reach their potential, reach their capabilities. And of course, all of the principles that he teaches are applicable to people in the so-called regular education curriculum as well. And in fact, a big part of what he taught was inclusion in how one can blend students of various abilities in one classroom and reach them all. And isn't that also indicative of how people of various abilities need to work with each other and can work with each other very effectively in the business world and in any other area as adults. But in any case, he made the observation that it's incumbent upon the teacher, the instructor in a classroom, to demonstrate a particular skill, to demonstrate quite deliberately the steps in the process, because that's how many children, whether they have special needs or not, learn. That's how they learn. And he actually made an observation that I've never heard before. And he says that even if it's a thinking process, that the teacher, it's incumbent upon the most effective teachers to think out loud. Even if they don't have to think out loud, meaning say it out loud to themselves, even if they don't have to in order for them to follow the process, that they think out loud for the benefit of the people that are observing them. And it just struck me, the parallel between that teaching principle and something that another great man that I've been blessed to be around, John Maxwell, who, oh, by the way, was recently named the number one leadership and management guru in the world, which I'm not surprised at all. Congratulations, John, of course. But I've seen him demonstrate this mastery time and time again. But one of John's favorite sayings is, the greatest leaders know the way, show the way, and go the way. So they have the understanding of what way needs to be, what path needs to be followed. They know the way. They show the way, just as my father-in-law said, they demonstrate it, they show it, and then they go the way, meaning their actions speak louder than their words. They actually demonstrate the principle, the action, because that is in fact how people learn, and that's how they gain understanding. We've all heard the phrase, you know, monkey see, monkey do. Well, guess what? People see and people do. People learn by illustration. People learn best by demonstration. So I challenge each and every one of you and the various hats that you wear in life, whether you're a parent or a teacher or a business leader or a business owner or a department lead, or if you don't have any formal authority over anyone at all, just have the influence of your presence around other people, that one of the best ways for you to influence others to demonstrate a particular mastery, to teach someone else something, is to actually show them, because people learn what they see. Again, my name is Ed DaCosta of eddacosta.com. I hope you found this valuable, and wherever you are, make it a great day.